Nibiru spotted again. Genuine proof, Planet X caught on camera. And he shows two suns rising in the sky. Well, there's a lot of people that seem to like sky watching, watching any anomaly in the sky. And this time, as Sebastian Ketley on Express UK reports, it has to do with amateur Planet X hunter, YouTuber, has taken a peek, pulled off to on the side of the road, and he claims that he saw something strange in the sky and decided to video it with his iPhone. And the strange thing is that he put an infrared lens on top of his iPhone camera in order to have a better shot at what was there. He used the infrared from his regular camera, his Nikon camera, he says, and all of these images and videos taken on his iPhone 7, standard factory setting, and this particular video having the infrared lens from his Nikon camera in order to get these strange red colorings. The whole video is marked by the deep red tint from the infrared lens, and he claims that it could be Planet X, Nibiru, Nemesis, Wormwood, Goblin, whatever you want to call it, brown dwarf star, black star, whatever is coming in. This is images from the video by David Jordan and his YouTube channel. At one point, Jordan describes how he quickly pulled onto the side of the road while driving in order to film Planet X Nibiru, which he called a dragon shape. He says, I pulled over quickly because I see the dragon, and lo and behold, I hold my iPhone up with the infrared lens taped to the front of it, as you can see, and I got Nemesis Rising, or Planet X, whatever you want to call it. So this is the sunrise. Other people have also claimed images of two stars on sunrise. Others have it at sunset. I have no idea how that works. I'm trying to see the sky in my area, but I'm having a problem because lately I'm having the same problem someone from England is having, in that we have this very strange yellowish-orange talc-y dust type of a cloud hanging over us. It started on Thursday morning and is still around. They're also chemtrail spraying us, but I can't see the sky at all. All I can see is this weird haze. It's not a sandstorm from Africa. You know, as most of you know, I live in Athens, Greece, and sometimes we do get sandstorms from Africa that bring Sahara sand onto us. But that falls after a couple of days because it's heavy. This thing here is so light, it's just suspended in the air. And it doesn't go anywhere, I guess, unless it rains, or it's not even windy. Or even if we had some wind, that would help take it somewhere else. So a friend, you know, a viewer, a follower of my channel, sent me a comment saying they had this strange pink cloud hanging over them. And I said, well, yeah, yours is pink, ours is like a yellowish orange. I guess depending on the intensity of the light, we have more intense solar rays here because we're more south. Maybe that's why mine looks more yellowish orange, and hers looks more like a pink. And it's still around us. Now, a lot of people are getting into this hobby, the hobby of sky gazing, let's put it that way. Some actually take videos and images. Others are much more serious. They even have telescopes. And NASA and other space agencies have asked amateur astronomers, or stargazers, to help them in reviewing some images that they have, telescope images, because human eyes are better than artificial intelligence scanning these images, and the amateur astronomers have already found bodies, potentially hazardous inbound bodies. They have found them. So that's great. You know, they do this as a voluntary work, and they have helped. And NASA is even asking for such help. And they're very, you know, some amateur astronomers are very serious about their work, and they have serious equipment, serious telescopes. They go to competitions, national competitions, international competitions. They show their images of what they take pictures of or videos of. And, you know, it must be a fabulous and a very expensive hobby to have. Now, we have recently had, a couple of years back, we had a solar eclipse, and we had it live coverage, and we even had, before that, the transit of Mercury at the, around the equator of the Sun, and we had the British astronomers from SLU telescope covering that, and they were talking about what they were looking at, and one of the images very clearly on their screen showed the Sun and the transit of Mercury, and it also had a very strange white fuzzy thing on the side, which looked just about the same size as our Sun. And when the commentator asked the astronomer about that image, what it was, he said, well, that's our binary star, what some people call Planet X, Nibiru, Wormwood, whatever, brown dwarf star, whatever you want to call it. And he confirmed that they didn't want to cover the truth, and they put it out there that, yeah, most star systems have a binary star, and so do we, he said. And that was really shocking, astonishing, let's put it that, shocking, astonishing, that very serious, here it is again. It's the astronomer was Paul Koch. You see him up on the upper right-hand side. And the transit of Mercury from SLU observatories, and the fuzzy planet, the image of the planet on the right. So we do have evidence of something out there. It's not as if there's none. You have professional astronomers, very credible astronomers saying that. You have the some kind of a planet crossing in front of the Sun in NASA images, and that cannot be done away with. I mean, that's out there for the public to see, and it's coming up now in a few seconds. That's a NASA image. What is that? That's huge. That is huge. Here it is. And a lot of people say that could be the Blue Star Kachina of the Hopi prophecy, of the Native American Indian prophecies that comes around every once in a while, every couple of thousand years. And I guess this ties in, of course, to Zachariah Sitchin's Nibiru, Planet X, coming in every 3,600 years. And that was, he came out with that about in the mid-1970s. And it could explain why a lot of superpowers are very hurriedly trying to construct underground dwellings, underground shelters, just like the ancients used to have. And the archaeologists have recently found all these shelters, like, for example, in Cappadocia in Turkey. And we're wondering, some of those were like for 200,000 people. And they even had an air purifying air conditioning system in the whole city, the underground city, maybe 20 to 30 floors. And why did they go into the trouble of building all that? How old was that, for goodness sakes? And we know that the Hopi Indians, the Native American Indians, had the underground dwellings too, because they say every once in a while you have this intruder coming in, and they have to have somewhere to go and hide and protect themselves for the longevity of the human race. This is also one of the prophecies in the New Testament and in the Book of Revelation, that men will try and get into the hide in the mountains, in the caves of mountains, in order to protect themselves from what's coming. The prophecy of Revelation 8:8 of a big mountain being thrown to the earth. Well, that to me sounds obviously like an inbound planet or an asteroid or a comet. And we've seen many instances of that. If you look at Google Earth, if you look at the north of South America, you'll see as if it looks as if, and the south of South America, between the tip of South America and Antarctica, it's as if the fingers of God have pressured onto the Earth's mantle, the Earth's crust, from the left to the right, on both locations, from the left to the right, and pressured and pushed the Earth's crust in. What did that? Comets? Were they at the same time? Were they soon enough, one after the other? But those are huge indentations on the Earth's crust. If you look at the one on the south between South America and Antarctica, it looks as if that landmass was joined and it was cut by this pressure, this object coming in and cutting that area. So, okay, then we have some NASA scientists coming out saying it doesn't exist. We had Neil deGrasse Tyson saying that. Then you have Dr. David Morrison, NASA's leading scientist, who came out and said there is no credible evidence whatsoever for the existence of Nibiru. There are no pictures, no tracking, no astronomical observations. He says, I can quite specifically say how we know Planet X or Nibiru does not exist and does not threaten the Earth. Firstly, if there was a planet heading into our inner solar system that was going to come close to Earth, it would already be inside the orbit of Mars. It would be bright. It would be easily visible to the naked eye. If it was up there, it would be easy to see. All of us could see it. Wow. Well, some people that have the time to look at the sky actually do see it. And also, Caltech astronomers have come out with the proof saying that something is pulling on the outermost planets of our solar system and changing their tilts and their orbits. And this something must be so huge, it could be anywhere between 10 to 50 sizes, the size of Earth, in order to do this. There's a gravitational pull on these outer planets of our solar system, which are huge planets, by the way. And also, not only pulling them, but also changing the heat of these planets for some reason. And there must be some kind of an electromagnetic jolt or something that's influencing the tilt and the orbits of these planets. Also, our sun has tilted 6 degrees. That's another weird thing. So we do have evidence. We have the SLU astronomers stating this with the picture on live TV that they showed. And we also have something that looks like a blue Gina in a NASA image. We also have the Caltech astronomers recently saying, those two young men saying that there must be something pulling. It's just a matter of 3 to 10 years before we actually find it and see it. NASA came out 2 or 3 years ago saying that we have a dark brown brown dwarf star at the edge of our solar system. And slowly but surely, every once in a while, they're telling you, giving you, they're spoon feeding us information that there's something out there to get us conditioned without getting us too frightened out of our skin. They're getting us conditioned. So I'll leave a link below for you for this on Express UK and tell me what you think. I'm trying to, as I told you, I'm trying to see what's out there in a nice guy, but you know, all of us are so busy. It's like a rat race. We're running around like little treadmills and we don't have time to look up in the skies. And even if we do, we can't see anything from these weird dust storms that we're having, these weird particles suspended in our atmosphere for days on end. They don't come down. And we can't see the sun. We can't even see the sky. And we also have compiled with that the aerosol spraying. You know, sometimes they're one plane, sometimes they're three planes all in the same line, one behind the other, as I saw yesterday afternoon. So even if we, I guess it's a matter of luck. Maybe you have to ask for rain, and then when it rains and the sky is clear, go out and look at the sun, or look at the sky. Okay, so tell me what you think. Thank you. If you'd like to join me on my Patreon account, you will hear content not covered by mainstream media. These riveting stories will be based on my research, and I will state my opinions and give my personal insight on diverse and controversial subjects and world events, events not covered by mainstream media, and not supported by YouTube guidelines. So whatever I have on my Patreon, most of those will not be on my YouTube channel. Please consider becoming a member today. More of the most significant and important videos will be on my Patreon channel. Your support helps me to continue my research and keeps this YouTube channel alive. And we depend on your support, your generous charity, because we help economically challenged families here in Athens, Greece, in Kapota, and we also help the young generation with university tuition and the community around our church. Thank you.